We continue our journey to a pet cafe for inspiration. Yeah, I know, most pet cafes don't mix dogs and cats, but let's go with it. To write our first program, we start with a task. We want to build an online pet cafe. Users of this program can create their own pet, give their pet a name and other characteristics, and interact with online pets. We'll want the computer to store this information so the user can come back to play at any time. It would be a lot to tackle this all at once. Most programming is done iteratively, meaning we start with a small subset of functionality, get that working as we like, then repeat selecting another small set of functionality until we have all of the features we want. Let's stop for a moment and think about this. Why would you develop a program iteratively? Ever have a really big task, like cleaning out the garage or re-landscaping your yard? It's hard to think through every small detail when facing such a large project. It's often easier to focus on one piece of the task at a time. With that in mind, we'll start our Pet Cafe app by selecting a simple task and breaking that task into a set of instructions. We'll use a form of pseudocode to write those instructions. Pseudocode is an informal way of writing program instructions without using actual code. We'll use actual code in the Gentle Introduction to JavaScript for Beginners course, but for now, we want to focus on how to think about programming, not about a specific programming language or syntax. For our first task, we want this. We break our first simple task into instructions. We define an input where the user puts or enters something into the program, in this case, cat or dog, and a second input asking how many of them. The application then watches for the user to click the Adopt button. When it's clicked, we tell the computer to perform an output where the program puts or displays something out onto the screen. In this case, it displays the number and type of pets. We then define a decision we want the computer to make. If the pet is a cat, output what a cat says. If the pet is a dog, output what a dog says. Lastly, we define a loop to repeat the message for each adopted pet. We have now written our first program, yay! Even if it is just in pseudocode. Want to give it a try? Here's another task. For this example, we want to create a number guessing game. In this game, the computer should randomly pick a number between 1 and 20, and the player guesses the number. The computer then tells the player if the guess is too low, too high, or correct. If the player guesses wrong, they can guess again. Pause the video now if you want to break this task into a set of instructions using pseudocode, like we did for our pet cafe. Are you ready to see what I came up with? The computer randomly selects a number between 1 and 20. The computer then asks for input, the player's guess. We have three decisions, defined with if instructions: what to do if the guess was too low, what to do if the guess was too high, and what to do with a correct answer. A loop allows the player to continue to guess until the guess is correct. How did you do? Was your solution similar? This example demonstrates an important point. With programming, there is often no single correct approach. We may each break down a task into instructions differently, and that's okay. There are multiple ways to think through any task and solve any problem. Diversity in how we approach turning tasks to code often leads to improvements in our result. Let's talk a bit more about our program's flow next.